Hello viewers, this is Pastor Reda, your host for Women in Action. Greetings from our Lord Jesus Christ unto you all. May his peace continue to be our portion. Today is another day the Lord has given to us, and I'm here to encourage you as usual, all the women around the world, especially Christian women. As I already explained to you about Women in Action, Women in Action is to encourage all the women around the world to stand up, to stand for our family, our nation, and our community. Today, I'm here to talk to you, our mothers, about our future leaders, that is our children. So I'm going to talk to you on a topic, our children, our future leaders. Amen. Shall we share a word of prayer? Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for another opportunity. We ask your presence to take control so that at the end of everything, it will give glory to you. We bless you for your presence in Jesus' name. Amen. Today, as I said, I'm going to talk to you about our children, our future leaders. You know, our children, they are our future leaders, and we need to encourage them. We need to stand for them because they are facing a lot of challenges in the world. So when I'm talking about our children, it's not only our biological children alone, but the children in our churches, children in our community. We need to stand for them as women. We need to encourage them as women. We need to pray for them, because this time that we are in, there are a lot of things that is going on, and we need to direct them in the ways of the Lord. I just want us to read something in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. If you have your Bible, let us read it. Now, this is the commandment, and these are the statutes and judgment which the Lord your God has commanded to teach you, that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess, that you may fear the Lord your God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments which I commanded you, and your son and your grandson, all the days of your life, and that your days may be prolonged. Hallelujah. This is the commandment from our God to our children. God commanded his people to teach all the commandment that he has given to them, to the young generation. Why? Because God knows the young generation, that is our children, they are future leaders. When we cannot do the things we are doing now, they are the one that is going to place us. They are the one that is going to take over. So God knew that. So he ushered his people to guide them, to teach them his commandments. And today, this is our responsibility as mothers to also do that. We need to teach our children the commandment of God. We need to guide them, because if we don't teach them, they will forget the commandment of God. Because now there are a lot of things that is going on in this world. So if mothers, if we fail to teach them, even though it's for both parents, but I'm stressing more on women, because we are with the children all the time. Our husbands, like I always said, are always busy. Yes, they do their part, but since we are always with the children, we have more access to talk to them more. So today, this is the word of God to every woman, that God wants us to teach our children his commandment, so that they will fear the Lord, so that they will never forget what the Lord has said to us. If we fail to teach them, they will also forget, and their future is going to be chaos. That is why we have to teach them the commandment of God. And it is the will of God also to do that to our young generation. Our children, they are our future leaders. You will bear witness with me that right now, the things that is going on, a lot of things, especially the technology aspect, is taking our children. They don't even have time to pray. They don't even have time to pray enough. They don't even have time to read the word. Always on the phone, always doing something different. Hardly you will see them reading the Bible. Sometimes I'm using my as example. When you ask them, they say, "Oh, mommy, all the Bible, everything is in there." So I'm not on Facebook. I'm not reading anything just like that. But I'm reading my Bible. I pray. But I know the phone distract them a lot. The technology aspect is taking our children, and we, the mothers, need to stand for our children and direct them. You know, I'm not saying it's bad, the technology is bad, but they have to know how to balance the life, how to balance the their Christian journey and other things. That is my point I want to make to our mothers, that we need to let them know, because sometimes we think they know enough, but they don't know. God knew that. That is why God told his people that, let your young generation know my commandments so that their life will be prolonged. We need to direct our children. They are facing a lot of things in the world, but our encouragement, our prayers will motivate them to read the Bible and also to obey the word of God. We shouldn't leave them, especially sometimes our youth, we think they are old enough. No, they are not old enough. No matter what, we will continue to be their mothers. We will continue to be their parents. So we need to bring the awareness of our youth, because sometimes we think, oh, they are old enough. No, they are not old enough. Mothers, I'm encouraging you. Let us try our best. Like I said, not only our biological children alone, but the children and the youth in the church. Let us draw closer to them so that they will feel comfortable to come to us and share with them the word of God. If we see them and they don't feel comfortable to draw closer to us, we can't have the access to direct them more. So today, women in action, let us be action for Christ by drawing closer to our youth in the church, our children in the church, and let them, encourage them. If you see them, ask them, smile to them and ask them, did you read your Bible? Are you doing your quiet time? If we do that, they will know we care for them. They will know we care for them. And for that matter, when they see you, they will say, this woman will ask me whether I've done my quiet time or not, and it will help them. They are our future leaders. Let us encourage them more so that they will follow the commandment of God. Let us encourage them so that they will take the things of God serious in their life. When you read Lamentation chapter 2 verse 19, let us read the word of God. I just want us to read something to you so that you will know that it is the will of God. It is the will of God for us mothers to stand for the children, because they are our future leaders. God don't want them to forget about his commandments, because when they forget about the commandment of God, in future, we don't know what will happen to them. This is the time we need to stand up and also encourage them. Everything about women in action is encouragement. Encouragement. We are encouraging our husbands, we are encouraging our children, we are encouraging our community, we are encouraging our nation, everybody around the world. That is why I'm stressing on encouragement more, because when you be encouraged by somebody, it motivates you to do more. Now, I want us to read something about how God wants us to pray for our children, how God wants us to stand for them. Lamentation chapter 2, verse 19. If you have your Bible, you can read with me. It says, arise out in the night at the beginning of the watches. Pour out your heart like water before the face of the Lord. Lift your hands toward him for the life of your young children who faint from hunger at the head of every street. This is the word of God. God says that as women, as parents, we need to arise in the night, which is midnight, while everybody is sleeping, and cry unto him for our children, for our future generation, for our future leaders, because our children are yearning for the worldly things. We need to let them love the things of God. We need to let them be established in the things of God. The Bible says that our children are yearning for the things in the world, because the things that is in the world is so attractive, and sometimes they want to copy. They when they see the celebrities out there, they want to be like them. But if we teach them the commandment of God, if we teach them they are different, if we teach them what God, the plans he has for them, they will know that they don't have to compare themselves to the world, but they have to love the things of God, because God says in Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11, God says, I know the thoughts I have for you. It's a thought of peace, not of evil, to see you to an expected end. God has a good future for our children. That is why God says that we should arise in the night, midnight, and pray for our children. We need to lift our hands every day and towards God, so that God will listen to our prayers. God will know that we are in for our children. We need to always call on God concerning our children, because God is the only one that has a future plans for them. The future that God has for our children is not evil, but it's a thought of peace, a future with hope, a future that when we see them, we will not cry or be miserable, but rather we will give glory to God and also be happy that we were able to direct our children in the ways of God. Women in action. Our slogan and our motto say, we pray for all situations and we fear no foe. Today, we are praying for our children. We are standing in for our children. Let's read something from Isaiah chapter 54, verse 13. The Lord said something, and I just want us to read it. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the peace of your children. Hallelujah. This is the word of God. If we encourage our children to avail themselves to the Lord, God says that he's going to teach them. And when God teach our children, great is their future. Their future is going to be peace. We were not going to be worried. Now, parents, mothers, we are worried, because the things we see around the world now is not encouraging. Our heart is pounding. But we know when our children are availed themselves to be taught by God, God says that great will be their peace, and we will also be at peace. That is why today I am here to encourage all the women around the world to be action for Christ, especially our Christian mothers. Let us stand up. Sometimes we are too busy. We are too busy that we can't even have a conversation with our children, because we think, they are okay. They are not okay. We need to have time for them. The little time that we have, let us draw closer to them. Let us have a conversation with them. Let us make sure and ask them they have read the Bible. Sometimes we should ask them questions, what they know about God, how their Christian journey is going. And I'm telling you, if we continue to do that, they will feel comfortable, and they will not even have time every day to sit on the computer and the phones.
mothers all around the world, Christian mothers, arise. God says that we should stand for them in prayer. I'm reminding you about Lamentation 2:9. Say that in the midnight, arise and pray for them when they are sleeping. That is when we need to arise and lift our two hands. God said we should do that. We should lift our two hands because the world is challenging our children. The world want to take our children, but the world don't have nothing for our children. The Bible says that the enemy, he came to steal, kill, and destroy. But if our children are established in God, if our children are established in the things of God, the enemy cannot steal them. They will defend themselves. As Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were able to stand for God when Nebuchadnezzar asked them to bow before the image, because their parents taught them about how they cannot bow to any other God, only Jehovah God. They were able to stand and defend themselves with the word of God. So we also have to direct our children in the ways of God. We need to help them establish in the things of God. We need to also encourage them to love the things of God. We need to point out to them that there is joy, peace, all that they want in this world. They can find it in the Lord, because it is only our God who can give them a peaceful future. Women, this is our responsibility. Our children, they are our future leaders. Let us not leave them alone. Let us not think they are okay. Let us not think we take them to church every day, so the word of God that is coming from the pulpit, they are okay with it. No, our pastors are doing their part. We also have to do our part. That is why God says that we should teach them so that they will never forget his commandment. Because when they keep the commandment of God, great will be their peace, and their life will also prolong, and they will also enjoy their future. Even when we are not there, we are not going to worry, because we know we have invested in them, in the things of God, and God will also going to take good care of them. God bless you. We are going to pray for them. I just want us to pray. Our prayer point number one, we are praying that anything that the enemy is using against our children, not to focus in the Lord, not to focus in their Christian journey, whether it's technology, whether it's anything that we don't know, let us pray that God should help them. Let us pray for them wherever you are. Pray for our children. Pray. Just pray for them that nothing will distract them. We want them to be established. We want them to remain in God, especially in this time that we are in, that nothing will distract them in the name of Jesus, so that they will stand firm. They will also defend themselves with the word of God when we are not around. Shall we pray? Father, we pray in Jesus' name. Your word commanded us to arise as parents, as women, to pray for our children. Father, we pray that let our children remain in you. Anything that is distracting them, we leave them before you, that help them to focus. Holy Spirit, our helper, we pray for our future leaders. We pray for our children so that they will be established in you, in Jesus' name. Amen. Our prayer point number two, we are praying, soaking them with the blood of Jesus, that the blood of Jesus will continue to speak for them. The blood of Jesus will continue to protect them, because sometimes they go to places that we are not aware. But once we commit them into the hands of the Lord, once we cover them with the blood of Jesus, the blood will speak for them. The blood will protect them. In the name of Jesus, shall we pray? Father, we pray for our children. Father, we cover them with the blood of Jesus. We pray that the blood of Jesus will continue to protect them, will continue to speak for them
on their behalf wherever they go, even that, even the place that they will go that we are not aware, because they are covered by the blood of Jesus. Father, we know that they are safe and secure in your hand. We thank you so much for answering our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Today, if you have prayed this prayer with me, let us trust God that God is going to protect our children. God is going to direct them. But we need to also do our part. When we do our part, God will also do his part. But these three quotations, don't forget. Number one, Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. God says that we should teach them his command so that they will not forget. Now, number two is Lamentation 2:19. God says that as mothers, we should arise in the midnight and pray for our children, for they are yearning for the things in the world. So when we pray for them, they will not love the things in the world. And three, God says that our children will be taught by him. It means that we need to help them to avail to God so that God will also teach them. Don't forget this prayer point and this quotation. When you use them to pray, God will also answer our prayers. God bless you. Women in action, we pray for all situations. We fear no foe. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord continue to favor you, everything that you do. May the Lord continue to give us strength to be in action for him. God bless you all. Join me same time, Sunday, 3 p.m. And don't forget to like the page and also share it to your friends. God richly bless you. This is your host for Women in Action, Pastor Rita. Bye.